Your footsteps are as loud as a Kaguri's. What is it you want, Outlander? Have you now? Then you have my thanks and my curiosity also. Outsiders rarely show us such respect. When they do, it is always because they want something. What do you want, I wonder? Remarkable. You would honor our ancestors. Very well. I give you my blessing. You hesitate. Shall I explain the custom? Each of the four great tribes seek a unique and worthy offering. You must place the gift at the foot of each Ashkan's cairn. For Ahemusa, an ashen fern. For Erebenimsum, the weapon of an exile slain by your hand. For Urshalaku, the bones of a Gwar returned to ash. And for Zainab, the hidden treasure of a Kwama queen. We will see how much fire you hold in your heart. Yes, though becoming is a clumsy word for it. Every daughter of Veloth has worth. When we learn to speak with our water tongue and read the truth in the stones, we also learn the truth of our hearts. The truth is, we have been wise all along.
You there. Keep your head down and come here. Hope you're not looking for passage off the island. The crew's on shore leave, see? The permanent kind. Probably tripped over a few of them on the way in. Poor bastards. Ugly business. A deal gone bad. I work for an orc boss named Kartag. We're ropefish. People smugglers. Slaves pay us out the arse for a trip to the mainland. When the Kamana Tong found out, they wanted in. Kartag told them to tusk off. Yeah. It came down on us like an arse-branded ogre. We gave as good as we got. It wasn't enough. Kartag and a few slaves fled to the cavern. Kamana gangsters right behind. Without help, they're as good as dead. Don't suppose you're the heroic type? Oh, good on you for doing this, mate. Kartag's an idiot, but he doesn't deserve what the Kamana Tong will do to him. Like I said, he went in with some slaves. Mobker, Jari Ito, and Wiwaska. You should drag them out, too. He should have made a deal. What kind of rock-headed dunce tell the Kamana Tong to eat their own small clothes? These aren't common hoods. The Tong will feed you to the slaughterfish for a hard glance, let alone insulting their mothers. Moloch knows. I mean, the Tong did have some ideas Kartag wasn't wild about. Upping the prices, chaining up the slaves en route, packing them into smaller ferries. Kartag refused to even consider it. Great time to develop a conscience, eh? Maybe. You'll have to ask him, provided he's not dead already. Kartag's a hard orc to know. I always thought he was a stone-hearted businessman, but then some horker out in the rift told me he was a big-time Covenant hero, so what do I know? It's a syndicate. A crime family. Everyone hoes them, from Tudrek Hood on up to House Counselor. If they put their thumb on a scale, you look away. If they tell you to pick something up, you snatch it up quick and thank them for the privilege. Trust me, dangerous is an understatement. I'd kick Maroon's Dagon in the rocks before I'd talk back to the Kamana Tong. I played dead. Performance of a lifetime, if you ask me. I guess those acting lessons weren't so useless after all. My mother wanted to make sure I was well-rounded. I play a mean flute, too. Wait, why are we talking about this?
see his
Keep it down. You'll wake the
That must have cost him.
Go with the river's flow to dead ones.